respecting diversity.
No. I have a slightly different perspective on this whole notion. And the point that I want to mention is, you know, the culture is gender agnostic. It's a backbone of the organization. Culture has nothing to do with the gender. Diversity is the flavor. And how rich and how interesting workplace or productive workplace or engaged workplace you want to make will depend on how diverse is your workplace. So I think, and this is a culture. So if your culture of organization has diversity in it, and if the culture says that we should have diversity across levels, not only at operating level, but in our firms and processes and in everything else, the way we approach our employees, the way we source them, the way we promote them. Diversity has to be in your culture so that it becomes, you know, collaborative and complementary to each other. You don't need to teach people to hire for diversity. They will want to hire for diversity. Is that the culture you want to bring in? Completely agree with the point made that, you know, mentoring and coaching is the primary motivator or influencer how that career of individual will shape up, right? And therefore, it is very important for you to have a mentorship program that is specially designed to cater to the need of the gender, if that is the issue or that is the area that you want to focus on. Otherwise as well. Because that brings in diversity, that brings in fairness at workplace. We conducted a study that, you know, our problem was that while my entry-level gender diversity was quite good at 40%, as we grew and as people grew up in the career, that diversity was going down. And we wanted to find out why is it. We saw that there is no change in performance. You know, the gender percentage is equally represented in my across performance level. So I didn't see any bias in assessing performance or delivery capability of male or female gender. So it was really intriguing to find out why then people are not growing. Are we not doing enough to help them grow? And then very interesting point came out, you know, almost 20% of the respondent said that, you know, they don't want to grow. They don't want to get into different jobs because the current jobs are more helpful to them managing their personal work-life balance. And getting into a supervisory role or getting further will bring in probably more expectation from them, which they don't find themselves ready, which is fair, you know, from an individual perspective, we should respect that decision. But it's obviously a point of thought that why would someone feel moving into a coach or a manager level will bring in more stress? That's a separate point of conversation. But the interest doesn't stop here. 50% of the respondents said that they were not communicated or prepared well by their managers for an upcoming opportunity. Which clearly says that there is somewhere in hindsight, there is this bias in manager's mind. Whether it's a conscious bias or unconscious bias, to probably get a little relaxed approach towards female gender when it comes to focusing on them on their growth and stuff like that versus other. I mean, from a data point, I'm not qualifying my statement there, but that's how the data says. And therefore, you know, our effort now is towards getting to those people more and understanding where are we missing? What can we do differently? How can we create more avenues to pull this lot, which is missing out on a lot of opportunities? This year, we call it Lead Her. This project's name is Lead Her. And it's aimed at, you know, our targets are very clear. You know, my front level gender diversity has to move from wherever we are to plus 40%. My non-agent, which I call it, you know, non-frontline execs, that diversity need to cross at least 25% from wherever we are. And this whole project is conceived on five pillars that, you know, I would not hesitate using the word discriminately providing an undivided attention by leadership to focus on diversity. So are you hiring right? Are you ensuring that you're not leaving any stone unturned? Point number two is, the whole program is built on five pillars. You know, one is we are equal, which aims at focusing diversity at the hiring level. Then the second one is Inspire Her. Now, Inspire Her is a series that we started running where we bring in female leaders from the organization and outside, connecting with this group, is talking through their their experiences of life and how did they manage. That could be a great way of storytelling where you can go and tell your people that, you know, there are enough female leaders in the organization who could be your brand. Third one is Let's Connect. I mean, this is another session where we are looking at creating one-to-one mentoring for that population, which we believe could grow into non-frontline roles, but somewhere not able to grow. Either they are not getting opportunity or they are not confident, they are not ready. Somewhere there is a notion that, oh, you know, I can't do this. And we want to break that notion. We want to break that jinx saying that you can not only not do, you can do much better than your male counterparts. And the last one is, you know, Build Her, which is a whole new paradigm that we are trying to bringing in this project, where create an ecosystem for a person to prepare her for the role much ahead before she is even ready for that role. So, you know, every organization would have some minimum goalposts, right? You know, your tenure should be this much, your performance level should be this much before you move to a supervisory role. And we say, don't even go there. Target the person maybe 6 months ahead of it, start working on the individual development plan, build their IDPs, build their clear succession module, and help them on the areas that they will eventually succeed in those goals.